The first thing we're going to do is divide this into three, like landscape or vertical, which is portrait. You could also do it in different shapes, like random shapes in triangles if you wanted to. But we're going to end up with three landscape paintings. What I'm going to do is measure it. See, I'm holding it above, but I'm not sticking it down. And then I'm going to tear or cut with scissors. Just, you may tangle it, untangle it, and then decide, have it nice and straight. And look, now if you want to measure it, you can. Or you could stick and then grab a ruler and see if these are about the same. If you're someone who prefers not to measure and have things equal, then you could actually be better off doing a random shape. So you might decide your first landscape is going to go in this shape. Press it right down. If you don't want it sliding down, you could actually just tape it to the table. So our first painting is going to be monochromatic. That means we have one color plus white. We could also do black, but for this one to begin with, we're just going to do the white. Always keep your tray away from your board, because like that, you don't want to end up with water and mess from the bottom of your tray. This is why we have the scrap paper as well. You need to set up with scrap paper. Just a reminder, for serving paint, you scoop it out on your palette and you wipe it on your tray. You don't go like this, we put it on our tray. Now with monochromatic, we are going to be mixing the purple into the white. So you want enough white that's going to last for your painting, because this is going to get darker and darker and darker as we go. So have enough white and just a little bit of color. Grab a brush for painting and for mixing. And then I'm going to take just a little bit of purple, tiny, tiny, tiny bit of purple, and I'm going to mix it into my white. When you're mixing, you can actually use the paint knife or a brush, but you don't want the paint going all the way up the handle of your brush. So use your bristles, so the brush part, to mix it in. And if your brush is really messy, then this one I want you to save as a mixing brush. So we're gonna put that on the scrap paper out of the way. And when we're painting, we'll use a different brush. Now we want a nice small brush. And with the light color, so with my white and that tiny bit of purple, you can choose any color, it does not have to be purple. We are now going to paint the sky. So I have a smaller brush, and what I'm going to do is hold it closer to the bristles, and I'm actually going to draw in my lines like a pencil. Just trace over it. If your paint is a little thick, you can add a tiny bit of water, but my paint doesn't need it actually. So that is number one, and make sure you have it exactly how you want it, because we are now going to mix the color, which means you won't be able to get the same color again. If you want to keep some aside, just in case, you could just scoop a little bit there in case you need to patch up anything. But what we're going to do now is take the purple a little bit more, that's probably a little bit much, and we're going to mix this to make it darker. Having that little patch of color next to it will help you compare. So if you think it's not dark enough, you can add a little bit more. But it should be very gradual. And you want to mix all the paint together. All right, so I think that's quite nice. So I'm going to use my small brush. Remember, when we dip into the paint, we dip, but wipe off the excess so it's a nice smooth coat of paint. It's not all blobby, it's not all up the handle, it's not on my fingers. And now for this one, I'm actually just going to paint the lightest color is at the back of the mountains. So it's only these little ones at the very, very back. Back into my paint. And this one here. Now, if you think like this color here is very similar, then I could add a little bit more purple so that I see it a bit better. And if your paint is a bit thick, see how my brush is blobby? Twist it on your palette to get off the excess paint. If you need a bit more control, hold your fingers closer to the bristles. And one last one. Here we go. So you want to get everything in that's this color, because once again, we're not going to be remixing it. If we were working on a bigger painting and thought we'd need the color again, then I would actually put 5 blobs of white and mix all the colors so you could come back and use them lots of times. This way is kind of a once-off use because it's going to get darker now because I'm onto the next mountains. So they are my light mountains. Now I grab my mixing brush. Don't get it mixed with your painting brush. Let's bring in some more purple. So we mix with the brush. Get it a little bit darker. Mix it right in. So you got lots and lots of paint. Twist that paint off and then put that on your scrap paper. Now I'm going to come in, mix your excess paint off because it will be the lighter color. So now we want the darker color. And bring in some more. This time we can bring in quite a lot. It in. Now remember, if it's a big area, just wipe the paint off so it's not up the handle, and I could actually paint with this. Big area, paint with a big brush. Squish the paint down. As long as your masking tape is pressed down, you can paint on it. Small brush. Remember, not blobby like this. We don't blobby. Twist. Paint off. Hold close. Landform. It doesn't have to be anything fancy because of the small space. If I wanted to, because it is the foreground, I could bring in trees, or I could do little flicks of the grass because it's at the front. When you're at the front, it gets darker and more detailed. Just little flicks up or little strokes if you would like it to look like grass. Let's bring in a little bit more pure down here. And then you could add a little bit of purple and black at the front so it's a little bit more like a silhouette. I might add some dots so it looks like almost like wheat. There we go. So that brings your eyes forward. So that is our first one. Now see how I've got this and it's a little messy? That's where, now I'm gonna wash my brush. So we wash our brush like this, rub it on the bottom. Don't put your cup here. I'm just doing that so you can see it in the camera. And then you're going to squeeze your brush out with your fingers over your pot. And then pat it dry with your paper towel. Now, if you were saving your colors as you went, so if you're scooping a little bit to the side, you would have these here where you could do a little patch up. So for example, this was my first color. So now I could come back in if I feel like maybe I want to put in a little bit of clouds or another layer of that first color. So these three paintings might take more than one class. So if that is the case and you need to pack up, what I would like you to do is to write your name on the scrap paper and then carry this on the scrap paper. So we're going to take it outside to dry like this.